The heroes of Japan today are fictional characters, and behind them are those who created them.
In this Paris suburb, the Japan Pop Show has become a must-attend event for fans of Japanese anime. Thousands of people of all ages gather at conventions like these, united by their love of manga, video games, and cosplay. Like 20-year-old Hua Sheng, who participates in at least 5 conventions per year.
Playing a character allows me to try things that I wouldn't do in real life.
In the crowd, where reality blends with the virtual world, we meet up with a group of cosplayers from Strasbourg who go by the name Iconic. Today, they've set up a stand to share their passion for kawaii, which means the culture of cuteness in Japanese.
I'm Fenui. I've been making costumes for 20 years. I fell into it as a child with the show Club Dorothée.
In manga, I discovered stories about magical princesses and fairies with fantastic powers. From one day to the next, I turned on my TV, and what I'd read in those black and white books became a moving image on color TV, and from then on, I couldn't stop dreaming.
Shiwasu is part of a generation that has grown up with popular Japanese animes, mangas, and video games. The social phenomenon originated in the 70s when the first mangas hit bookshelves. Around this time, the first animated series like Astro Boy, Goldorak, and Captain Harlech began broadcasting. Over the next 2 decades, Japanese anime flooded France, especially thanks to TV shows like Club Dorothée, introducing cult series like Dragon Ball and Studio Ghibli films to the French youth.
I discovered this on a kids' TV show, but mostly with my father at a flea market when I was 7. In a crate, you find a Goldorak and a Raiden. These are objects from another time that are witnesses of the first time that all this Japanese fantasy arrived in the West.
38-year-old Baptiste Caillot has kept these precious memories from his childhood.
So here we have the Black Fire, which is a unique piece. And it's actually a tribute to both robots and samurai armor.
We meet in Versailles, where his unique collection of 300 toys and robots from this period are on display. He's dedicated 20 years of his life to carefully preserve the items with their original boxes and instructions.
This collection is like a thread that connects me to that period of my life and allows me to always remain a child. It was also the first time in France that there was this notion of merchandising. They were flooding the market with them, and children were totally receptive to this imaginary world that was completely overwhelming them.
To understand this influence, one has to turn back the clock to the end of the Second World War in 1945. Japan was under American occupation. The United States wanted to change Japan's military image to that of a peaceful nation. The Japanese adopted Western culture through the exchange of technology without leaving their traditions behind. This marked the beginning of Japanese bunka power, or soft power, and the development of nation branding. The anime and video game industry became a cash cow for the country, which brought in hundreds of billions of yen each year.
Japan is indeed a superpower from a cultural point of view. If we're talking about pop culture, which is widespread, but also high-end culture, traditional arts, which are now recognized for their true worth.
sont aujourd'hui reconnues à leur juste valeur. Ça va servir.
It will serve the image of this country. It will serve not only its appeal, but also its economic growth. Because it will generate income, develop tourism, and a multitude of activities linked to this cultural dimension.
Today, France is the second largest consumer of mangas in the world, after Japan. In large part thanks to cosplayers like Shiwasu, who continues to share her passion.
Thank you, Paris. You were incredible in supporting the cosplayers.
We have these moments of pause, of wonder, of escape, just by putting on a costume and meeting up with friends at a convention.
These conventions allow Shiwasu and her friends to escape the responsibilities of daily life and return to their childlike spirit.